I don't know why I'm putting my hand down like I could possibly. I think we're going to get started. Let's fuck it. Let's get started. Vapor Central, how the fuck are you tonight? Oh, look at that. Woos. We heard them tonight. That's amazing.
Nice. They're paying attention.
You're listening to the CK Podcast. K-Trip, hey, take it away.
Hey. Before you get started, Cal.
What's up, Opus?
I just want to make sure you don't forget. Never forget how awesome you are.
Go fuck yourself, Opus.
You don't get these stickers from fans.
Yeah, no one gives
I do.
It. Let me see this.
No. You're going to do something
bad. I'm going to tear it up, you cocksucker.
I know
Who's
you
the
are.
The lesbian?
Bless you, Opus. This is Opus from our lead-in show, Opus Live.
Nice. You guys have a good show, guys.
Thanks, Opus.
Opus is the man. I love Opus. Big round of applause for Opus, everybody. He's the shit. Made multiple. Were you down in Windsor? You drove 1,000,000 hours. He's the man.
Now for the legal stuff.
K-Trip.
You are listening to the CK Podcast. CK Podcast is not affiliated with Louis CK, Calvin Klein Cosmetics, or anyone who might actually own the trademark to the initial CK. We are merely Cal Post and K. Trevor Wilson. They are our initials. We came by them honestly, and we're just trying to steal a little bit of internet traffic. Is that so wrong?
No, it's not. No, it is not. K-Trev, how are you?
Not bad, bud. Not bad.
Good weekend?
Up and down weekend.
Up and down.
Up and down weekend.
Must have been hard for you on the knees.
Yeah. My aunt passed away Friday night on her birthday.
I'm sorry to hear that, buddy.
Thank you very much. Very sudden battle with pancreatic cancer.
Oh, it's a rough one.
Found out about a month ago that she had it, and it's one of those things that they just didn't give her a time frame. It was like, this is eventually going to kill you. We don't know when.
How old, if you don't mind my asking?
She was in her 70s. So, I mean, she lived a long time.
No, she lived a life.
Yeah. Lots of kids and grandkids. But, you know, it's always sad to see someone go.
Absolutely.
She's requested no funeral and memorial service, as she always hated those.
Yeah, who likes those?
No one really likes them.
No.
But, in lieu of that, she just told us all to toast her often and tell people that you love them as often as you can. So
that's
the message
sweet.
Going forward. And I love all of you.
Fuck you.
Thank you.
I love you too, K-Trev. Our guest today from SiriusXM Radio, a great person, wonderful comedian, Ben Miner. How are you, Ben?
Nobody died. I'm going to start things off on a lighter note. K-Trev, how are you? Heavy. Super
K-Trev
heavy.
K-Trev always starts off
Yeah, I
heavy.
Start off heavy, and then we get lighter.
Nice.
K-Trev never stops being heavy.
How about a big round of applause for K-Trev at fucking Just for Laughs, man?
Oh, thank you,
Bob. Yeah, K-Trev kicked it.
This guy got written about in all the newspapers, talk of the fest right there.
And you're still in Canada. Couldn't have been that great.
Yeah. Well, I've got my American, you know, agents and contacts. It's
and then I will
just
have
a matter of something coming from them. I do eventually have to go down there, but I do like it here.
Yeah, me too.
Like, it's the one problem is everyone's like, you know, you got to go to the States. Why aren't you in the States? I really enjoy Canada. I like living here. I like being here. I wish we could do more here.
Yeah, but at this point in your career, you've almost hit the ceiling of
what
you can do here.
And, you know, unless I get a show on the CBC, that's really the only thing left.
And that's amazing because 3 years ago, you had no credits pretty much in stand-up.
I wouldn't say.
Oh, no, you were fuck all.
2011 was when I got my first festival, so yeah.
Busted your balls.
Yeah, 3 years ago. So before that, you dicked around in the pot rooms.
A lot, yeah.
A lot, which is where you got picked up for Winnipeg, which is insanity.
Yeah. I'm probably...
Never let anyone say the pot rooms aren't worth anything. They are
true?
Fucking fantastic.
Yeah, I think Al Ray and I talked about how I was the first comic in history to get a major festival out of a pot room because Al saw me at Boyd Banks' Saturday show.
There you go.
When he used to host on Shrooms at the Underground.
I remember those.
And
here are the rest of us sending in tapes like a bunch of bums.
Yeah.
Yeah.
K-Trev's just getting
ripped. K-Trev's high doing 80 minutes of ego-jacking.
It was the week of Irwin's Memorial, which is why everyone was in town. And Boyd invited them all to come do the show, and I showed up on Saturday because Boyd had asked me to do the show, but like everything, he was high when he asked me to do it. Boyd always asked me to do the show and then forgot that he asked me, so I'd show up, tell him I was there, and he'd be like, okay, babe, I got to see where I can fit you on. Then he'd wander around the room for a bit, and then he'd come back and inevitably go, all right, I got to throw you up at the end because that's the only place I can put you, so... You're going to be following, you know, Scott Thompson, Kenny Robinson, then you.
Or it's gonna no be, problem.
It's going to be Tim Steeves, then Mike Wilmont, then you.
And that's, no problem.
Boyd made me a better comic by giving me a trial by fire.
Nice.
But that's when, I did my swinger story. So I talked for a good 10 minutes on a sex club, and Al Ray and I had a good half-hour talk after that, and he helped get me in the fest.
About a sex club?
Huh?
Was a half-hour talk about a sex club?
No, it was a half-hour talk about the Winnipeg.
Everybody writes
comedy.
A half-hour long. It's boring as shit.
I wouldn't even last a half-hour in
long.
A sex club.
I just talk slowly.
Sorry, when you speak, it feels like a half-hour. Get to it, buddy.
But
that's funny.
Your voice is perfect for theaters because it's so long and drawn out. It has so much time to reach the back, come back to you. It's you're perfect.
K-Trev's answering machine message times out before he's done.
Hello.
You've reached.
John Steinberg said this guy's really slow.
Thank you.
John Steinberg rolls the best joints. I love his fucking joints because he rolls them half filters.
Oh, is that what he does?
Yeah, man. So you get this nice long filter.
That's hilarious.
And it's still
it
the length
like
of a joint on the end.
Such an old man thing to do.
It's awesome. It's great for passing around. You're never worried about losing the filter.
And then
it's like smoking an ice cream cone.
Except there's a delicious part to the ice cream cone that you get to enjoy afterwards. And with the giant
filter. Dude,
man, filter.
If they made filters out of edible weed.
But with the giant filter, if it's half the J, then if you forget that, you're going to smoke a lot of filter.
That's true.
Yeah, but if you can't tell the difference between the filter and the weed, you're probably too high. You don't need any more weed. You're done.
I got it.
You're out.
Steinberg is one of my favorite guys. Like, whenever he tweets something, it's just very literal.
It kills me, man, because he's like custom made for Twitter. I've gone off on him so many times saying you should tweet more. And he's like, nah, I spend time on my jokes.
I never fucking tweet, but I tweeted today. Yeah. I'm going to pull it up.
What did you tweet?
Here's what I tweeted. Wait, close that. Close that. Where's my tweets? Messages? No, notifications? Where do I find my shit? I don't even know how this fucking thing works.
K-Trev and I are just going to talk about the weather while you do this.
Yeah. No, I got it. It's right here.
Yeah. Okay.
It's right here. Where the fuck is it?
Lickety split.
I wrote it down. Something along the lines of...
Aren't you supposed to be good at technology? Isn't that like your thing?
Yeah.
Twitter. Like, you know, Cal makes websites.
Yeah, I can make fucking websites and apps
shit.
And
but
edits.
Cal
can
take your
a
phone
Twitter
and
thing.
Fucking tell you that we really landed on the moon, but you can't find a fucking tweet.
Yeah, tweets, Twitter, I'm just not good at it. But I did. I tweeted about... I saw two 80-year-old guys in a fist fight. And it fucking floored me. I laughed.
Nice.
So I laughed walking past them. Because not only were they in a fist fight, they had cronies. Like three other 80-year-old dudes on either side, like shit-talking each other.
Why did you keep walking?
Oh, I had to go drink.
No.
Where was that? Where?
That was down up... what's west of Ossington? What's that fucking shit?
Dufferin?
High Park?
Dufferin?
High Park area.
You just drinking in the park?
Or like Roncesvalles? Or?
Yeah, like that area.
Oh, my neighborhood.
Yeah, but these two 80-year-old dudes just going at it. Fucking laughed. So funny. Because one guy's throwing real punches. The other guy's got like his fingers up and he's trying to hit him with his palms. Like
nice.
That guy never went to war.
David Carradine.
Or he's got arthritis. This
Maybe
is the best
that.
Fist he can make.
But it kind of upset me. I was like, what do they possibly care about enough?
Pussy.
At 80.
Pussy.
It can't be pussy.
It's
at 80.
Always pussy.
If I care about pussy when I'm 80, I'm going to be dead well before
it's
that.
It's not even pussy they've had now. It's pussy they had 50 years ago. Like 40,
that, I think
50
that
years
was my
ago.
Tweet. I hashtag is I fucked your
yeah,
dead
the old
wife.
Guys, they could be just from. They were from neighboring villages in the old country.
And they, yeah, and they both banged the same
They
chick.
Can't let that go.
No.
But don't you think you'd hit 80 and be like, nothing fucking matters?
You'd think.
You'd hope.
Nothing matters
but
at all.
But maybe that
all.
Extends to, I'm going to fight this fucking dude.
Yeah. I've been waiting.
I've never
I've been
fought
waiting
someone.
40 years to punch this
yeah,
piece of
I
shit in the head.
I fucking hate this guy. I'm going to just clock him.
Watching an old guy take a fist in the face, that was pretty funny.
It's like slow-mo in real time.
Did
it's
they
so
both,
slow.
Did they both stop to take their teeth out?
No, no, they had some. But one guy, yeah, one guy took it in the cheek, and he looked like he became a young man. Like he had that fire in his eyes. Maybe that's why they're doing it, just to relive youth.
Old man fight club?
Yeah, yeah, octogenarian fight club. That's funny.
First rule about Fight Club is, what was I going to say?
It's too hey, warm guys. In here. Hey, audience, you guys all like deaf or just smoking shitty weed?
Why would
you yeah, the whole audience of Vapor Central, are you all deaf or are you smoking bunk weed? If you feel the necessity to yell that loud, man, this is ridiculous, people. Everybody in this place is shouting and no one. There's a show on the friggin' stage. Like, show the guys some fucking respect, will you? Like, I mean, anybody, like, I can hear some entire conversations up here. That's pathetic.
Sean
That's
Brady.
Sean in the back.
Sean Brady in the back, everybody.
That?
Big round of applause.
That was freaky.
Sean scared the crap out of everybody.
For a second, I was like, is that me?
It's great. Sean has to do that from the back because he has the body of a 13-year-old girl volleyball player. So he has to make sure no one sees him when he talks like that.
He's deceptively strong.
You can turn up our mics a bit, too. That wouldn't hurt.
Sean has caught me when I fainted. So.
What do you mean by when you faked it?
Okay,
I greened out
that.
Here a few months ago. And
epically.
Yep. Oh, yeah. I was coughing and I forgot to breathe. And
you fainted?
I lurched forward, kicked a chair, and then fell into Sean's waiting arms. And then two other staff members rushed over to help me up. And I, in my head, I thought my pants were falling down. So I just struggled to keep my pants up. But it was a useless struggle. They were up.
And when you woke up, your butt was sore.
That's just because I have hemorrhoids.
Yeah.
How's XM treating you these days, buddy?
It's good, man. We just did a big competition. I just went all over Canada.
Is that still going on, or is there a winner?
No, we've got our finalists now.
You're one of them, right?
I didn't make it to the finals.
You didn't make it to the finals. The first competition K-Trev has not made.
I lost to Pat Thornton.
Yeah.
Just a one-off? Like, just against him?
It was K-Trev, John Steinberg, and Pat Thornton. And the Toronto
we were
Rams.
The Toronto finalists, and Pat got the most votes. And congrats to Pat, funny comic and an old
very
buddy
funny
of mine.
Comic,
and
very
then
funny.
The secret prize was
yeah, the secret prize was he gets to open for Russell at the ACC.
That's all right.
And we did not know that was a prize. I probably would have tried a little harder. As if the 15 grand was not enough incentive.
Jump change for K. Trevor Wilson.
So oh, I really could have used that money.
Who's in the finals?
Darcy Michael in Vancouver, Dan Taylor in Edmonton, Chantel Morassic in Winnipeg, Tom O'Donnell in Hamilton, Pat Thornton in Toronto, Adrian Cronk, Ottawa, Faisal Butt in Montreal, and Stephen Coombs in St. John's, Newfoundland.
I know a bunch of those guys, but yeah. I got to say, I think Pat's got it in the bag.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
There's no one as seasoned and no
Darcy.
One is. Oh, shit, I missed Darcy. Pat can take Darcy.
Oh, shit. K-Trev, what do you think?
Well, I mean, there's some sleepers that, you know, people don't, you know. Morostic is very funny. I've worked with Chantel in
She's
Winnipeg.
Great.
I'd love Tom to get it, but Tom can't open for Russ.
He is.
He is opening for Russell.
Tom O'Donnell's
yeah.
opening for Russ.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tom's in the finals. All of our finalists are opening for Russell across Canada. Everyone I just
theory.
Named for, to.
Oh, that's yeah. going to be fucking hysterical. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, Tom is
Tom's awesome. Tom will kill it.
Tom is the exact opposite of most of Russell's audience.
Not most, all. All of his audience.
Tom's going to crush it. You watch.
Tom hasn't heard of the country some of that audience is from.
Tom hasn't heard of a lot of things domestic, though, to be fair.
I don't think Tom has met an ethnic person.
No, he has. He has. He lived in Toronto for a bit.
Yeah. I think he came here like, what Tom the fuck is that, it. Bud?
I'm sure he's hit on some women of ethnic origins.
He'll do fine.
No, Tom's a funny fuck.
His comedy comes a lot from how dumb he is. And he's able to use his... It's interesting how he's able to use his own ignorance so well.
Yeah.
It's almost clever how dumb he is.
He's fun to hang out with just because his eyes tend to wander. Like, he's paying attention, and then you lose him.
I wish I would have grabbed I've got this video on my laptop. It used to be on my phone. It's a Tom showing everyone his giant nut.
Oh, yeah.
He does have one giant ball.
Yeah, he had one ball where the seal got ruptured by a hockey puck.
Hydro seal.
Yeah. And he just got this huge fucking nut. And the best was, Tom, I'm just going to start naming stuff. You tell me when I approximate something like your nut. I'm like, grape. He's like, no. Walnut, no. Kiwi, no. Peach, no. Somewhere between a peach and a big kiwi. That's how he described it. And then I called bullshit, and he whipped it out.
Oh, he has no problem.
No, it's worth. And it's hilarious. He goes, buddy, this thing is a party pleaser. I took it out at a party once. Everyone signed it. I was like, I bet none of the signatures overlapped either.
It's the same as Spike in the Punch.
Yeah, it's horrible. Looks like he's got a baby in a headlock when he squeezes it.
Yeah, it's horrific. It's
it should be its own.
I don't know how he sits, man. Like, when he takes a dump, that for sure hits water.
He's got to lift it up.
Yeah.
Got to hold it. Cradle it.
You'd think
so
it would provide him some sort of cardio having to lug that thing around all day.
It's a big nut. Yeah, it's a big nut. I should have found. Oh man, should have dug out that video.
Opening for Russ.
It's great. Yeah.
Pat's very strong, but I mean Darcy's solid.
It'll be Darcy or Pat.
Faisal's funny. Adrian's funny. Everyone's funny, man.
So what's the grand prize if just making it to the finals?
$15,000.
Yeah, $15,000.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Not too shabby.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah. Everyone's really funny, man. It was a good year. Like, we got good people.
I set myself up with a consolation prize on the day of the finals. I will be recording Laugh Out Loud taping in Guelph.
Oh, yeah, I remember you were saying because you weren't sure if you'd be able to do it or not.
Well, I was going to make it work.
Yeah.
But now I don't have to. I just have to go to my original gig.
You shouldn't have told them that. But you should have, like, let them know. You know what? When you found out Pat won before, like, it was totally public, you should have called CBC and been like, I pulled out of the competition because I'm really... really committed to working with you more. Yeah.
I'm really committed to laughing out loud.
Yeah, exactly. Do that.
Oh, boy, now I got to figure out what I'm doing.
For Laugh Out Loud?
Yeah.
Do baloney face.
Yeah, do baloney face.
It really doesn't work well on the radio.
That's what you made the final three with.
Yeah, but there
Dude,
was a
man,
video.
You don't move on stage. What the? Of course, it's going to work on radio.
Yeah, you're right.
The whole thing. You don't move your arms hardly.
My whole act is designed to work on the radio.
Yeah, it is.
You would have been at home in the 50s, 40s. Radio is your place to be. Because visually,
I'm very striking.
Says your mom.
Do I look like a growth off of K-Trev right
You're like
now?
If K-Trev had a mole on his back.
Yeah.
You're my mini-me.
Yeah. I'm just strapped to his belt.
Hey, you want to cut to a video? You want to see me dump an ice on my head?
Huh?
Yeah, and I got a video for later that we can call for. Who do I tell what video to play?
Kayla in the back. But
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Chris and Aaron Goodwin are not here this week.
Are they out in BC?
I'm assuming they're out in BC.
Who's Kayla?
Kayla and Dan, they're our producers today. Kayla, big round of applause for the beautiful Kayla, everybody. Please, big round.
Who's Kayla?
No one gives a fuck.
I don't know who it is. I want to play a video later, and I know the name of it. Can she look it up?
Yeah.
Can I say it now?
Yeah.
Hey, Kayla, is she paying attention?
Yeah.
Nice.
Go for it.
Can we get Canadian as fuck queued up?
Do you want to just play that right now?
Canadian as fuck?
Yeah, Canadian as fuck. It's on Funny or Die.
Okay, just one second.
Does it need a setup, or is it pretty self-explanatory?
It's self-explanatory. It's just two dudes. You'll see.
There's a video I've been meaning to play for a couple of weeks. I don't know if anyone's
seen. Let's play your video first at the ice.
Well, she's got to look. She can't do both. She can't put up a video and look for yours at the same time.
Okay.
We'll just play yours right now.
I'm not a robot. I can play whatever one you want. Just
let's play the Canadian as fuck. Let's start with Canadian as fuck.
Give it a second so it doesn't crash.
Okay. Take your time.
Is it going to be on the screen, too?
Yeah.
What?
We are live on Pot TV, Mark Emery's Pot TV.
Really?
And congrats on Mark's release.
Yeah, big round for Mark Emery, everybody.
Way to
big
get out
round.
Of the clink.
Last Wednesday, he was returned to Canada.
Out of the clink, man.
I couldn't make it out last week for personal reasons, and I was ashamed to miss a lot of the celebration that was happening here at Vapor Central and in Windsor as well when they went to go meet him at the border. That was a fantastic celebration they had. It was streaming all day.
We had the toast of Mark Emery here on Wednesday and Thursday.
Yeah. I missed that.
All the comedy shows got the fucking boots.
Yeah, they got bumped up to 7. They were early shows last week.
I'm ready with the clip whenever you guys want.
Let's play it up.
Also, I just want to remind everyone at the back of the room that they're talking really loud.
I think we have a lot of new people here tonight.
All right, so this is...
I know you're excited,
this
but
is
just
Canadian
quiet
as fuck?
Down a bit. Don't yell at each other.
controversy in Vapor Central.
It's a great one.
Hockey players.
A couple of hockey players come down the laneway the other day.
Call me later. Hi, boys.
Jesus.
Bye.
Great day for hay, eh, boys?
Did you get her done?
Just kidding, we don't give a fuck.
Wheel snipe, Sally, boys.
Dirty fucking dangles, boys. Had a sick day with your sisters, buddy.
Fucking C-Doo's a hunty pee, buddy.
Ladies love the flow, bro.
Sickest flow, bro.
Buddy, the only thing ladies love is when you quit talking.
What'd you say?
You heard me. Buddy, you're softer than a Tootsie Roll fruit cup.
You look like the skunk my dog killed and probably raped.
Get your board shorts out of here, you fucking pansy.
Take your tank top and your Tonka truck and kick rocks.
Cake eater.
It is a great day for hay.
What's it to you?
Boys.
Boys.
Boys. Boys. Quit talking the same. What, do you share a set of testicles and a tongue?
Get real.
I bet you got a handful of names for your own horn, don't you, bud?
Smell like nachos and you look stoned.
You write Taylor Swift lyrics and birthday cards.
You prefer kittens and you kiss babies.
You're fucking 10-ply, bud.
Fellas, that was some of the finest tripping I've ever received.
Ever. Oh yeah? Did we get her done?
Just kidding, we don't give a fuck.
Keep away from my sisters.
Glad they walked, because it would have been awkward asking to take a piss before a fight.
Oh, that was fucking great.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of those. They're awesome.
The Canadian as fuck on
yeah,
Funny or Die.
And YouTube, but yeah, I saw the one Funny or Die. Funny or Die.
You write Taylor Swift lyrics and birthday cards.
Yeah, I think that should be pitches of TV show. Those two guys are awesome. The dude with the shorter hair played Don Cherry in the CBC movie.
No shit.
Oh, he played he played young Don Cherry.
Yeah.
That's right. Those movies were shit. It's too bad.
Yeah.
Not that Don led the most exciting life.
He had a pretty exciting life.
Yeah, he coached the hockey team.
yeah, but I mean, he pretty much, when did he get Hockey Night in Canada? 50, 60?
No, it was like, what, the 80s?
Yeah, when he was 50 or 60, he's 100 now, right?
I thought you said the 50s or 60s.
No. When he was 50 or 60.
Yeah, I don't know.
The Prime Minister. It's what my buddy's dad used to call Don Cherry.
The Prime Minister.
Coach's Corner came on. He'd say, quiet, the Prime Minister is talking.
I love him. I think he's
funny
as fuck.
Made my friend look like an idiot on the fucking first.
Hey, should we talk about, the ALS video. Should we talk about, I want to do that auction thing? And if anyone has any ideas as to how to get this auction going.
So Ben just can't give away money. He's always got to have some weird, eccentric...
I
want to
give money, too, but this is... Yeah, we'll see if we can get
so
more
Ben
money.
Wants to do an auction. Ben's an amazing cook. He was on MasterChef Canada.
Yeah, man. Top 16.
Top 16. Boom, baby.
And
boom.
All of Canada. Fucking awesome.
So this guy can cook like a motherfucker. So to raise money for ALS awareness and towards a cure, Benny here wants to auction off him. He'll come to your house. He'll cook for you. You'll do the dishes, right, buddy?
Yeah. Nicest paper plates ever.
He'll cook for you a nice meal, something sweet.
Something delicious.
So if you're interested, we're going to do a web thingy.
Yeah. And I've been taking a lot of pictures of food lately that I made, like one of those assholes. But at least I make the food.
Oh, like Instagramming it?
No, I don't do Instagram.
You're one of those Insta freaks?
I don't know how to Instagram.
I'll get Cal to teach you. He's a computer.
Yeah, yeah, I can do all that stuff.
Can't even tweet.
I can tweet. I just can't find them after I do it.
You probably didn't even send it.
I did. I sent it.
Did anyone like it?
I don't know.
Isn't that funny? You see somebody with like 100,000 Twitter followers and none of their tweets ever have likes.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be great.
No, it happens all the time. Those are people that buy followers.
Oh, that's such bullshit.
Yeah, yeah.
What a waste of your time. And how do you feel good about yourself?
No, because I know some people that did it, and then they end up getting gigs based on people being impressed that they had a shitload of followers.
Yeah, but then they go to the gig and they suck. Because they suck doesn't just apply to one aspect. If you suck at one aspect, you're probably shitty all across. So if you're shitty enough to buy Twitter bots, you're probably a shitty comic.
But if you're a shitty comic before that wasn't getting work... Anyway,
I don't condone what they do.
No, I don't either.
And you'll burn your own, you're burning your own bridges.
Yeah.
Because you'll do the Twitter bot thing, get followers. Ah, someone's impressed, they give you a gig. You're going to go ruin the gig, and then that guy's never going to book you again. You're doing yourself a disservice.
Yeah, I know, I agree. But I think these dudes aren't going to get booked anyway, so. They were never getting booked in the first place, so. The disservice is whatever. At least they got to do a good show.
I've always my rule of thumb with comedy. It's not a rule; it's personal, I guess, but a guideline was to stay off of everything until I felt ready to be in front of people, like open mics, working it out.
Yeah.
And I didn't want anyone to know who I was until I knew I had something.
No, I just put whatever out there. K-Chev? I haven't tweeted in a while, actually.
I didn't want anyone to see me when I was starting and have that shitty set. Because when everyone...
Yeah, no, I don't get it.
Videos?
Yeah, videos, put myself out there.
I used to record my stuff, but I used to just do audio. You know, like I'd have a tape recorder on stage with me, and I'd record it so I could listen back to it. It was years before I ever posted anything. And I think the first video I ever put up, it was... I needed to... put it online to enter a contest.
Fuck, in the early days, I almost got beat up so much.
I believe that.
I had no grasp. There's a wonderful little part of my brain.
Very volatile,
that's
angry.
That's a camera?
Set.
Yeah,
that's a camera.
Yeah, we're live.
Holy shit, look how small that is.
Yeah, we got one right here, too. Boom, it used to be my cock cam.
Really?
Yeah, it used to be mobile. I used to put it where my dick is, and I'd pretend to jerk off.
Look at that.
I'm glad they moved it.
I'm glad they took away
your cock cam.
The best is when we had Andrew Barr here, and he has one of the best tattoos I've ever seen in my life.
What is it?
He's got an X-Wing
flying
shooting. Into his ass, shooting lasers. So his ass is like the Death Star. So then I took the camera and went around his ass following
that's
the ship.
Funny.
Bum, 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 bum.
I fired guns on Saturday.
Oh, did you do Mike McGregor's podcast?
No.
Oh.
No. I had a bachelor party, and we went to a gun range.
What kind of guns you shoot? I love guns.
I shot an AR or something. I got video of me shooting a 50 cal.
Oh.
Yeah. Handgun and a handheld single barrel shotgun.
Well, fuck, while we're into guns, you guys want to get into gun laws and how we feel about America's gun laws versus our gun laws and all that junk?
We're pretty gun loving here. It's just you can't buy them at Walmart.
No, you can't. But you also can't.
Gotta go
I don't
Sears.
Like, I don't, I'm against gun control. Not one of my most popular.
Why what, do you mean, what do you mean gun against control? Gun control?
I don't like the government controlling what kind of guns we're allowed to have. That's what it all, that's what it is. I don't like the, I don't like that the government can have guns and we're not allowed to have them.
Well, they're not allowed to have the same, they can't fucking
a cop
walk.
Can walk around with a gun on his hip. And that's
so can you.
No, you can't.
You
not
can
in this country.
You can apply for a carry license.
Not in Canada.
Sure.
Not a carry.
Really?
You can apply for a license. It's, I think it's either no one gets them or everyone can have them.
I think cops should all
you
have
to go through the same training. I don't know. You just can't hand out guns on the street. Like, yeah, you can't. You can't carry it on your person.
There's a lot of gun enthusiasts in the audience.
Which I know when I'm being held up, I got to go to my trunk, unlock it. Take out the box, unlock the box.
But so does the criminal, right?
Well, no, the criminal isn't.
No, joking.
What a long... Anyway, but that...
You can't conceal?
No, you can't conceal here. You can in New York.
Yeah? So just move there.
Well, they wouldn't give me a visa to go there. That's a whole different thing.
Man. But there's bigger problems in the world than not being able to carry a gun.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, of course. Yeah. But then, it, by that rationale, you can't really argue about anything.
I don't know who posted it today, but it was smart. It was on Facebook. They said that every cop should have a camera, like the dash cams in Russia.
There are cities and precincts.
They should all have gun cams.
They should have GoPros.
No, there's a...
Like on their shoulders.
There's a couple states have done that, I think, where, or at least cities where they have badge cams.
Yeah.
And
they do a lot of just for last gag type stuff.
they said that incidents have gone down and complaints of police brutality have gone down. And
Toronto police, is this on?
Yeah, it's on. Go ahead.
Toronto police have lapel cams now. They tell you when they pull you over. They say you're being recorded. It's a little lapel camera right on there.
Good,
oh,
good.
Because yeah?
I know cool. They're not too keen on people videotaping them.
My buddy's brother's a cop, and they have to, when they get into their car now, they're voice recorded the whole shift, so they can't even joke around about things anymore. They're pretty strict right now.
Good, oh, wow. Good. I like that.
Yeah, probably the whole Sammy a team thing. Yeah. They gotta be really cracking down.
I think the cops would be a lot more respectable if they didn't know who was carrying.
What?
It's a joke.
I didn't hear you.
Was that Brian Regan's joke that everyone should have one free kill?
Yeah.
Not because he wants to see people get hurt, but he just thinks everyone would be a lot nicer to each other.
Yeah, you don't want to be that one guy's kill.
It's like, hey, you know what? We finished your car early.
Oh, I was such an asshole in my 20s. There's no fucking way I'd made. I would have.
You'd
made
have been
it.
Dead.
I would have been dead immediately.
Someone would have used a free kill on you.
That, or
sure.
I would have been sober. I never would have started drinking. One or the other.
Maybe.
God, I was a terror in my 20s.
Didn't you go to high school with Tom O'Donnell?
Sure did. Yeah, he was much younger than I was, though.
That's funny.
He's a good 5 years younger than I am. Smarter then. I don't know what he did between grade 9 and now, but he's fucking dumb.
That's funny.
He's a funny kid. I love him.
Tom is one of those guys that when you crack a 2-4, he believes you have to finish it that night.
Oh, yeah. You don't have that rule?
Huh?
You don't have that rule?
No, I'm a grown-up.
The beer will go bad.
Yeah, right. And the vodka will spoil.
Just say it. You might as well drink it.
There's still people talking about cop stuff. Disarm the police.
I'd like to disarm the police. I think
good
that's a great idea.
Over there. I'm hearing
I don't that. Understand.
It's not going to work out because you got... Criminals are going to, carry guns.
I don't know why cops aren't trained to go taser first. Like the kid on the streetcar. Why wasn't that a taser incident?
Yeah, they don't have enough guys trained to do tasers.
Why don't we just throw
what
shit at each other?
What training do you need with a taser? It's easier than a gun. If you know how to use a gun, I think a taser.
I think we need to go back to a primate state and throw feces at each other.
Only a certain number of cops have the
step
tasers.
One.
only and are allowed to use it.
Step one, throw shit at someone.
I don't
someone.
Think your mic is on.
It might be turned down in the
we
back.
We should just throw shit at each other. I can't stress this enough.
Like monkeys.
Yeah.
Throw poop.
Yeah, like escalate. Because then you can't even fucking fire a gun with shit on your hands.
True. If you got hit in the face with shit,
and then while you're
you'd be like, what did I
then
do?
Then while you're cleaning your hands.
Hold on, wait. What was that? They are. That's what they're starting to do now in certain places. They're go-camming.
They have lapel cameras.
Yeah, but then they're just going to hire fucking Hollywood editors to go in and change that shit. Digitally put a hoodie on a black kid.
Did you say go-cam the cops? I mean GoPro. You're
yeah,
too
go-cam.
Young to mess
yeah,
that
yeah.
up.
That's
you're super
meant.
Young. You should know technology.
Are you going to... It's
like, I'm jealous of his youth.
People on semantics.
Does that really happen? Man. Man.
I do think the cops should be held more accountable for what they do. They
well, they shouldn't be allowed to clear themselves.
Yeah.
He is going to jail, the guy from the streetcar. Good, good. Would the kid have a steak knife? Yeah, he was mentally ill with a steak knife. No. Guy in a wheelchair with Down syndrome, they push him over? Was that here in Toronto?
Speak in the mic or...
Oh, no, that was in Florida. He was a paraplegic.
There's great cops, too, by the way. There's awesome cops,
too.
There
are. And the officer didn't believe he was paralyzed, so she dumped him out of his chair. Oh, that's a different video, then.
Jesus Christ. Then they... Ah, man. What an abuse of power. My mother was a cop.
Really?
She went through all the training. She stopped. She was injured. But she told... Like, when she broke down what training was for a cop, to me, it was they break you down to nothing, and then they rebuild you.
Man.
And they pretty much turn you into... This is... They make you believe that the law is the law, and that's what's right, no matter
Man.
What. No matter what, this is the law, and it is right. And anything beyond that, like they don't think outside of that. Mm. And some, I'm sure some do, obviously. There's good cops. I don't want to say there's not good cops out there.
Yeah, of course, I
like a police force. They do serve a purpose.
Oh, yeah.
My buddy Miller was always a cool dude. He's a cop.
I knew a guy... This guy was cool as shit. He was an undercover cop in Toronto for like 10 years.
Yeah.
And he ended up putting away a bunch of heavy dealers. But when he came back out of undercover, like during undercover, his wife left him and his kids. And like his life went to shit while he was undercover. And then he said the hardest part was putting away what became his friends.
Are you sure you're not thinking of Donnie Brasco?
No, I'm not. This is a guy I actually met. Because when I met him,
they wouldn't... Donnie Brasco.
Yeah.
Turns out it's a lot of people's story.
But they wouldn't let him be a cop when he came back. Like,
wow.
They wouldn't let him be a street cop, so he worked at the desk in the office. But he still had his car, so he'd let me in the car, and I could play with all the fucking bells and whistles. It was a blast. He was a cool dude, but you could tell he's a bit tweaked out. Because he got to do all those drugs, and he said it was really hard. He made all these friends,
Man.
And then he had to help lock them up.
Yeah.
It's like when I was in Boy Scouts.
What was that?
It's like when I was in Boy Scouts.
You had to lock up a lot of your meth friends?
You know, it's just hard to get out. It's once you know the life.
I went fucking for one day, and I was like, no. Yeah. I was nine.
I remember I was like 9 years
Cal
old.
Cal doesn't handle rejection well.
This is,
when the
this
troop
is one of my
didn't
favorite
make a pass at him. He's
this
like,
is one of my favorite place. Stories. I was like 9 or 10 and in Boy Scouts, and I was walking to a meeting, and I had my brand new starter jacket on, and these kids tried to roll me for it. And I just, my uncle always told me, if some kids try to jump you, just punch the biggest one in the face and run. And that's what I did. And I ran up to the Boy Scout meeting. Now, my neighborhood was like a tougher neighborhood in Ottawa, which is a bit of a contradiction, but ignore that.
The tough neighborhood
in
Ottawa.
And as we left to go play this game in the neighborhood, which is basically a big giant game of hide and go seek. Everybody knew what had just happened, so they all grabbed hockey sticks and baseball bats. And I remember my buddy Alex grabbing one guy by the throat and pinning him up against our elementary school wall and bitch slapping him.
Oh, that's awesome.
Like, full on goes, I want names. In a Boy Scout uniform.
Dude, if you're a man strong enough to hold down another man and just slap him mercilessly.
Yeah, Alex is a big kid.
That is one of the coolest motherfucking things.
Throw it against the hand against the throat.
And just to be strong enough to hold a guy still and then just slap him silly. Yeah.
That is really cool.
It was hilarious. A bitch slap.
Imagine it be that cool in grade 7 or grade 6 or whatever it was. It was grade 6 or 7, however old you are on that. 10? 11?
Yeah, I went to the Boy Scouts. For me, in the country, like, it was down the street, so I walked over. And it was everyone singing together and playing games together, and I was like, I fucking hate this. I hate this. I hate this camaraderie.
Yeah, the togetherness and happiness was foreign to Cal.
It wasn't in my bag.
I think K-Trav's checking his phone because it's not like he's busy right now.
Did you get another gala somewhere? Do you have to put on your gala cape and dance out of the room? No, there's a gala to be done.
It was just Dan Gallia asking me to do his birthday show.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
I like Dan. I don't know him well enough, though. I'd like to get to know him better.
Dan and I went to college together.
Humber College.
He was with me at my year in Humber. And was one of the founding members of the Skechersons.
Yeah, and then the Boom.
Yep.
Now Primo.
Yep. That Roseanne opening is a thing of beauty.
It is.
Did he head right for all those sketch troops?
Yeah, I don't know if he head wrote for Skechersons, but he wrote a lot.
He wrote a lot.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to play a video.
ALS video?
No, I don't want to play that video.
I want to play it.
Okay, let's play the ALS video.
Cal did the water bucket challenge.
I did the ice the bucket challenge. I dumped ice on my face. For a good cause. What? Oh, here we go. Hey, that's me in my backyard.
By the way, Cal, looking fit.
Thanks, buddy. My name is Cal Post. Don't think I didn't do that on purpose. Because I did.
Whose dog is that?
That is my neighbor's dog, Ginger.
Andrew Downey and his
You can't really hear it. I'm just saying who this is for, my girl Joanna Downey.
That I know, she's great. And I also challenge two-time Just for Laughs gala writer Cleve Jones. This is on the start of Joanna Downey, where I'll donate to her directly at joannadowney.com. Anyone can do it. All right, here we go.
So that bucket is full of water. Full of water. That is 3 bags of ice. And what I didn't do, what I forgot to do, was crush up the ice.
Yeah, you put, like, huge chunks in there.
Yeah, there's massive chunks in there.
Did you concuss yourself?
That was a big fuck-up on my part.
Go hard or go home.
Oh, that's a lot of ice.
That was a lot of ice.
That helped a little.
All right.
Is that a hose?
Holy fuck!
So I'm not saying fuck because of the cold. A chunk of ice fell on my foot and sliced it up bad. So I got these slices in my foot. That was me freaking the fuck out. That's what the fuck
ice
came out of.
Ice slice.
And I cut it off there because I wanted everyone to see it, but the rest of the line's like, fuck, it's son of a motherfucker. Like, it just keeps going. I should put that one up.
Yeah, you should. The uncensored version.
What's going on, Matt Oliver?
What's up, Matt?
Did you see the one of PK Subban? Did you? He had the entire Zamboni. Empty its ice bucket on him. It took about a minute and a half.
Oh, that's fucking great. Can we find the PK Subban one?
It's the most intense one that there is.
That's
so
awesome. Good for PK. I don't think he deserves $9 million a year, though.
No.
No. What is
look, they had to pay him.
And fuck him for teasing the Toronto fans and commenting on, you know, how, you know.
What is he, 50?
Maybe not right now, but.
Is he, what, a 50 point?
It could be nice to play for your home team. And then go and sign a fucking huge deal with Montreal. Like,
did you see that obituary that was going around?
Yeah.
Where the guy in his obit asked for the Maple Leafs to be his pallbearers so they could let him down one more time.
Yeah, I heard that.
That's awesome.
Here we go.
Oh, here we go. Crank up that sound, baby.
Just brewing. And I got all these people here watching me. What's going to happen if I pee myself?
3 minutes.
I'm a little nervous. Yeah, I'm a little nervous.
Come on out.
Load it up.
You say what's going to happen if I pee?
Load that. Yeah, load that.
Price?
Up.
Price?
I want the
Subway
whole
and Reebok.
Thing. I want to be floating on King Street when that thing opens up.
Okay.
All right. I'm serious.
Now you were challenged. Remind us again. Was he a 50-point and by your GM?
I was challenged by my brother.
What's
Alex
how many points
Galgenia,
season, on average? 50?
And my GM, Mark Bergevin.
How many points?
I'm
going
this
in, baby.
$9 million for 50 points.
Part of this is you have to challenge someone, right?
Yeah, yeah, I gotta bring it in what? Close for this one because I want everybody
he's in his early 20s and he's still one of the best.
First of all,
yeah,
I
he's great. He's fantastic.
Yeah, hopefully. Yeah.
So I'm calling out.
Everyone's an injury away.
Drake's gotta do it.
That's why they never signed anybody to 8-year deals before.
Phil Kessel.
4 or 5 years, man.
Sit down. Sit down. We gotta sit down.
Phil Kessel to do it.
No, sit down and you can do that one after. Okay.
You think Kessel's got the ball?
No.
Okay, ready on the count.
Get out of there, PK. Get out of there. It's not worth it.
He can't get shown up by a Montreal Canadian.
Two, one.
Oh. Oh. That'll be tough to beat. That'll be tough to beat.
Jesus. This might be the best one.
Yeah, Cal, you're a pussy.
Okay.
I like that he's got a cup on.
And?
Oh. Whoa.
Okay.
Oh, that's awesome.
I forgot to call. I got one more I'm calling out. Jeff Molson, owner of the Montreal Canadiens. He's got two. I love
him.
Your lips are blue.
They're blue. I was so cold.
Jesus.
We're going to wrap up this.
The dude who's paying me. You got to do it.
This place kind of front was protected right. There. Everything was deflecting off his broad
That's
shoulder.
Still fucking cold, man.
Anyways, you guys have a good night. It was fun talking
to you.
Thanks, man.
Thanks, buddy.
It was awesome because I got called out by somebody online who I don't really know that well, but he called out everybody, which was, you can't really do that. It's kind of, he's like, just everybody do it.
Yeah.
So I was like, fuck it, I'll do it. And it's kind of started the spur in the comedy community.
Nobody's called me out yet.
It'll get there.
Yeah.
Yeah, Pew did his today.
Pew
and
did
I saw
his.
Jeff Elliott's.
Yeah, Jeff yeah, Elliott's is great. Pew's. He was in a suit.
Yeah. Kate Davis's was great.
Cleve Jones. Cleve Jones is awesome because I've been outing him as, he's now got 2 punchlines in taped in Just for Laughs gala sets.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so he wrote a tag for Hempstead. You ever hear his pie joke? Great, great fucking bit
yeah.
on pies. But Cleve had the Google line at the end. Google Britney's pie. That's Cleve. Good for Cleve.
Nice. Cleve Jones.
Yeah. Semi-pro comedian has a joke. And then he did... Then he got quoted in the Gazette. Mike Wilmot did one of his lines, and it got quoted, which was he quit smoking, and he can't use the patch because the patch doesn't do anything. He'd have to sit by a campfire in a nicotine onesie. Yeah, and that got picked up by the Gazette.
Nice.
So good for Cleve. Very proud of him. He's the fucking man. I love
Cleve
that guy.
Cleve Jones.
Yeah, he did the ice challenge. A lot of people are doing it now. It's fantastic. I should have called you out, man. When I was calling people out, though, I didn't know who would take it seriously. Like, I didn't know who would do it.
Yeah.
I didn't know everyone was on board to do it. And then there's people online shitting on it.
No, there's always going to be people.
There's always going to be people who are like,
there's always
going to
be some dickhole with
like.
Too much time on his fucking yeah. hands. They go, oh, you're not really helping. It's like, and you're doing less than helping.
Yeah.
If people don't know what Lou
you're
Gehrig's,
not even pretend helping.
Brr.
People don't know what Lou Gehrig's is. It's a horrible disease.
Oh, ALS is Lou Gehrig's yeah. disease.
Yeah, it's a neurological disease that they don't know why it starts. They don't know what causes it. And there's actually no test for it.
Yeah.
They test for everything.
It's degenerative.
And yeah. So, the conversation between the brain and the muscles just doesn't happen.
Yeah.
And they have no idea why. The brain can be fine. The muscles are fine. And there's no visual damage
knows.
Anywhere.
There's no, like, they don't know. They don't know if it's, like, family or what. Like, there's no
yeah, they don't,
there's no clue on it.
They don't know if it's genetic, so we need money for research right
yeah.
now. Because it's also one, it's as prevalent as MS, and everyone knows what MS is,
yeah.
but ALS has no spokesperson. Stephen Hawking would be the spokesperson,
yeah.
but he's a little busy figuring out how the universe was made.
Yeah, that and hanging out at the Playboy Mansion. I saw
yeah,
those
yeah.
pictures.
Yeah, he's a bit busy. I was like, yeah, of course he's not going to.
Yeah.
I don't blame him at all. He's got a lot going on in the noodle.
I guess he's got some shit on the go.
I believe he's also the longest living person with ALS.
Yeah.
The life expectancy is 3 to 7 years for anyone who has it.
Yeah, because you think, well, the money must have a big thing to do with that, right?
Definitely the first guy with ALS to divorce a hot chick.
Who did that?
Stephen Hawking.
Really?
What does he care?
He left his super hot wife to marry a new super hot wife.
That's really funny. You can imagine take the cock. You can take the cock out of the guy. But
yeah. I think we should see
the
other
around.
People.
We need.
My love, this doesn't work for me anymore.
I love you, but I'm not in love with you.
It's not you, it's me.
We're on separate paths. Yours is not wheelchair accessible.
That's funny.
That's hilarious.
I'll write it down. So anyway, yeah, it's a really great cause, and any money towards the research is a wonderful thing.
It is like the worst possible.
I mean, it's one of the most.
It just shuts everything down except yep. your brain.
Yeah, and in the case of my girl Joe, who was diagnosed 2.5 years ago, she was also diagnosed with dementia, FTD, which happens in about 7% of ALS patients. They can't make a connection, like a scientific connection, say this is what's causing this, but it does happen in about 7 to 8% of patients. So it's frontal lobe dementia, so it's your higher function where you keep empathy, conversation, most of your emotional.
Yeah.
So
shitty,
yeah,
man.
It is. It's one of the worst diseases.
I can't imagine because you become a prisoner of your own body, right? Because you're conscious. It's not like
In most cases of ALS, your brain is completely aware.
Yeah.
But, in a lot of cases,
everything else doesn't work.
Yeah, it's just like you're kind of oh man.
I heard a story of a man. He had ALS. This just story. I just liked it. It's like that's it. That's I hope I go out like this. Like this kind of man. So he had ALS, and it he had it quickly within 2 years, done. So he was laid up at home, could barely move, had a little bit of arm motion left, and he started choking because he lost the muscles in his neck. So he started choking, and his family went to go call 911, and he waved them off. How fucking manly is that?
Man.
Oh! That's like, nah!
Hardcore.
Nah!
Hardcore.
Let me be.
I found my out.
I'm going to cry. I'm going to be such a baby on my way out. I'm going to be grabbing.
Oprah's got a nice bucket challenge.
Oprah's got one. Put. I need this. Okay, put on Oprah's ice
Oprah's.
Bucket. I need.
I want to see Oprah's high beams. Let's see this.
I want to respect her for something. This will be great.
Oprah, your high beams flashing. Warning. Let's get that going. Imagine the fucking crazy story would be if there was an Oprah sex tape.
Oh, I think she's far too smart for that.
Man, whatever. People still got their kinks. She could have a fucking sex tape.
She could afford to buy the internet and shut it down. Don't call it hilarious.
It just says she gets involved in it.
I bet you it's only humorous.
Why can't we hear?
Crank it up!
There's barely anything in that. It's weird.
There's barely any water.
There's barely anything in it. It didn't even get her face.
Yeah, but then she probably gave $5 million to research.
Yeah.
Yep.
And that was just what was in her wallet.
Yeah.
I found it underneath the sink.
Yeah, ALS can have this.
Good, it's us.
Not hilarious. Mildly entertaining.
It's funny because my point of view is like exactly what I see on TV. I just see K-Trev's head right here, then Cal on the TV. But then I look and Cal's there and it's the same thing.
and onward and onward into infinity.
That was a very high statement.
Kayla, can you put on the Venture Brothers clip?
We lost internet, so hold on.
Okay.
We lost
crashed the show?
Crashed the show, everybody.
Yeah. Oprah broke the show.
Lock the doors. Orgy time.
She heard we were making fun of her and shut us down.
Shit, can we play the Oprah thing again? I didn't look for her high beams.
There were no high beams, buddy.
There's no high beams?
No.
Is she wearing pasties?
Just a very strong Brazilian.
Whatever, I'm not alone.
I haven't seen a babe do the ice bucket challenge yet.
No.
Have you looked that hard?
Yo, what? Oh, you're talking to that
guy. Oh, they don't know how to do the bag thing.
He's just eating the bag. Is this how it works? I just eat it?
So just let it go till it blows up, right?
Yeah, I haven't seen any babes doing the ice bucket challenge. I'd love to see a group of babes.
Yeah. So
someone should challenge some babes then.
I'm going to do it again. Unprovoked. If you guys get challenged, you got to challenge babes after this.
Okay.
Only babes. Specify bikinis, small ones.
Nice.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can do that.
I want to see chunks of ice and cleavage.
Challenge.
Hard nipples. What else? What would raise more money than hard nipples?
Oh, sad, sad kid faces?
No, not even, man. You can turn away from a kid, sad kid face. I turn away from those channels all the time.
All right, well, the ice...
For just $1
a... Kayla's talking.
Sorry. The pro wrestler thing or something else?
Sorry, I couldn't hear you, hon.
The pro wrestler thing? What clip did you want again?
Oh, no, the other one that I sent, the
Venture Bros.
Venture Bros.
1 second.
Sorry, dear.
Can we watch another Canadian as fuck after?
I thought you only sent me one.
This is the problem when our
guests
get high.
I only sent you the one? Oh, I thought so. Both.
I will double check. I'm the worst.
When we started this show, and I think we were getting too high at the beginning of when we started, and we eventually just started watching YouTube. Like, that's what the show became.
That's
hilarious. We'd talk like a half hour. There was just like a half hour of videos.
It's comics talking.
There
about
should
YouTube.
Be a second link under the first link. We are organized.
No, it is only the pro wrestler thing.
All right, then let's show that.
Okay.
Way to go, K-Trev.
What was it called? I can look for it, maybe.
It was Venture Brothers, Worst Tits.
Somebody should just dunk Andrea Ruda in a bucket of ice.
Tips or tits?
Tits.
Did you say dicks or tits?
Yeah.
Like breasts?
Yes. Okay. Worst Tits.
Breasts.
It's the name of the clip. Venture Brothers, Worst Tits.
Worst Tits?
Yep.
Oh, could you imagine a world without tits? I'd kill myself.
Oh. Ad.
Ooh, the NBA store.
Boo.
Titties.
That was right and reasonable. I can pole dance better than half those.
Make sure the sound is up.
Good Lord, son, there should be a mandatory retirement age for strippers.
You see, I got cornered by Robin last night. I almost had to chew off my own arm to get away.
Oh, that poor woman has the saddest tits. Damn depressing.
Right? Yeah, they're like the notebook sad.
Tits are like coming home from school and finding out that your old man ran over your cat sad.
Mournful. She has mournful tits. They're like two suicide notes stuffed in a glitter bra.
Those things are like a little kid with progeria cracking all his ribs trying to catch a Nerf ball. Just sad. Damn it, she has gloomy tits.
It's like she put a dollar's worth of change into some old socks and then taped them to her chest.
I want to build two little caskets and give her tits a tasteful, dignified funeral.
Jail boss, locking on and in pursuit.
Disengage, Sam.
We couldn't hear from the beginning, but they were talking about a sad pair of tits.
I heard. Code white operation. We're all buddies on this one.
Sphinx Fighter, this is Control. You are cleared for landing. Over.
Copy Control. Over.
Is that H. John Benjamin?
No, it's Patrick Warburton. Putty. That's from the Venture Brothers. Which the sixth season is coming out. Any Venture Brothers fans out there? And if there's not, you should be. It's an amazing show to watch on POT.
Oh, man. Another great show that I found and I plowed through so fast, Rick and Morty.
Oh, yeah. Great show.
Holy fuck, that's funny.
I haven't watched it yet, but I hear it's good.
It's fantastic.
It's Community, dude. Dan Hartman, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's just filthy and so goddamn funny. The characters are great. Every episode's made me laugh. Brr. If you're going to watch a show, I suggest that one. Oh, let's talk about who saw Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
I did.
It's fucking great. I'm going to say it. It was fucking awesome. How can I ruin it? It's they started out as little turtles, and then they became big mutant Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Which original story? They've done it a few times.
At the end, you find out the turtle is actually dead and that he was talking to a dead person.
No, that's the Sixth Sense.
Oh.
Bruce Willis just turtles. Looks like a turtle.
I didn't see Ninja Turtles.
Yeah, the origin is they fell in the ooze.
You're one of the few people who liked the movie.
Yeah, because I didn't go in there expecting fucking The Dark Knight. I went in there going, it's a story about giant mutant turtles in their teenage years.
You're a story about giant mutant turtles.
Shredder was badass.
I guess mostly I've been talking to Horwood, and he hates everything because he's convinced he could have written it.
That's because secretly he hates himself.
And
if he likes anything, he thinks that looks bad on him. Anyway, Ninja Turtles is an awesome watch. It's fun as fuck. Lots of ninja stuff.
Yeah.
Really easy story. It's for kids. Never forget this stuff is for kids.
Yeah.
I mean, if they made the real-life Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, you'd have giant mutant turtles who were horny as fuck not doing ninja stuff. Walking around with these weird mutant turtle boners.
Turtle dicks.
Trying to fuck. It would
dill
be
pickles.
Weird. It'd be
Everybody's
fucking weird.
Everybody's getting poked with dill pickles.
Yeah, so you don't see the turtle's penis?
No.
Do they wear pants?
No.
Weird.
Maybe it just like goes inside of them. A
cloaca. Like it does in real life.
A cloaca.
They did a great job of separating the turtles. They made them all look very unique, unlike all the cartoons or the other movies where they all essentially are the same with a different color band. They're all very unique and funny in their own way.
Like you could tell them apart even without the different colored headbands?
Oh, yeah, for sure. They're different sizes. Very different personnel. Yeah, it was really fun. Because people, you know what's going on? Like,
is Michelangelo a party dude?
These fucking assholes are going in to review the movie.
You didn't answer my question.
What was that? What's
is Michelangelo a party dude?
Does
yeah,
he
man.
Say
he's
Cowabunga.
The partiest of dudes.
Does
he's
he
got like a seashell necklace. He's got the thumbs and the pinkies up all the time.
So he's Guy Fieri?
Yeah, man. He talks like a surfer dude. It's great. Dropping lines like Cowabunga? Fuck yeah.
You posted that article that takes a big dump on Fieri.
I can't stand Guy Fieri.
He doesn't eat eggs.
He doesn't
makes
eat
no
eggs?
Sense to me.
He no. doesn't eat eggs.
Doesn't like eggs. What
the fuck's wrong with him? Eggs are delicious.
I love
He's
eggs.
The only Food Network dude who doesn't cook.
Is that the guy with blonde hair?
The guy that looks like the fucking Smash Mouth asshole.
Oh, that piece of shit.
Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Triple D.
What does he do? Just go around and eat?
Just fucking eats everywhere. That makes people do stupid food game shows. I've never seen him cook. Because he's always talking about how he can't cook. Ooh, that's in my wheelhouse, baby. This ain't my first rodeo. Fuck off, you frosted tip.
He owns a bunch of... Does he own a restaurant?
And they're abominations. His restaurants are horrible. The only reason he's anything is because he was the first Food Network star. I've never seen him cook.
The fact that there is a Food Network star is pretty funny in itself.
I hope they bring it to Canada.
Society loves food so much.
Well, they have.
People have become celebrities of food.
That's Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives.
You know how fucked up that is?
Huh?
That's Fieri's show, Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And they have the Canadian version, You Gotta Eat Here.
Yeah, but I'm saying I hope they bring Food Network star to Canada.
Oh.
Do you know what kind of weird obsession?
Okay, where it's a game show to be a new host?
Yeah.
Okay. Because
I don't like that the Food Network exists.
I really don't.
Why?
It's such a weird thing to me, giving away a job in a reality show.
Yeah.
It's so weird to celebrate food like that.
Why? We celebrate other things.
But
and at least then you can learn something. You learn how to fucking cook. A lot of people don't cook because they don't know how to cook. I learned how to cook by watching those shows.
Yeah, but how many shows are teaching you how to cook properly with the right types of things you should
now?
Be eating?
Now, a fair amount of them. I mean, then
like how many are telling you just to eat?
They still have straight up cooking shows.
There are straight up cooking shows, but then there's like most of them now.
Most of them now are food competitions.
Yeah, they're competitions, or they're just like
yeah, like Cake Boss, right? Who can make the biggest fuck off cake? What a dumbass.
Well, Cake Boss is just a reality show about a guy who makes ridiculous cakes,
and not on the Food Network.
Okay, what's the other cake one then? Isn't there like a cake competition?
That's the one with Duff. What's his name? The Charm City Cakes.
Oh yeah.
Whatever it's called.
And who's that fucking asshole who yells at people when they cook?
Ramsay.
What a piece of garbage.
Ah, whatever. It's for TV.
He made, because he became popular when I was still working in kitchens, and all of my chefs wanted to be Gordon Ramsay. They just couldn't wait to fucking yell at
you. He was a professional soccer player.
You'd be like, fuck off, you're not Gordon Ramsay, I'll punch you in the mouth.
To care that much about food, you're mental. You have a mental issue.
Every head chef is that way. They're running an entire kitchen, man. They got to yell.
They're passionate about
scream.
Food like you're passionate about being angry.
This is touche. Touche, K-Trev. For me, like, I perceive food.
To them, you're mentally ill because you're just angry.
I woke up real pissed off today. It's just a bad day for me, all right? I had a great weekend, and whatever. I don't know. I woke up at 5
a.m.
And
you just woke up mad.
I woke up
for
so
no reason.
Fucking mad. I don't know. I'm having one of these fuck the world days.
Cal jerked off and then wiped his eye by mistake.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. I don't know. Just a dose of a chemical in my brain. I just woke up. It's like, I want people hurt. It's just a weird feeling.
Yeah. Yeah. Almost like you're messed up in the brain.
Nah. It happens every once in a
like
while.
Like a lunatic.
I think it's just pressure.
Like one of those food people.
No, here's the thing with the food, though. I perceive it's gasoline. It fuels your body. And
see, that's because you don't like... You're a skinny dude saying this to two fat guys.
Yeah.
Does it look like we got a lot of fuel?
Yeah, but I also eat properly and specifically.
Yeah.
I follow a very specific diet.
He just makes everything into a juice.
Yeah, Cal's more in a feed than food.
Cal just drinks his meals.
Cal just makes pastes.
He doesn't enjoy them. They're just nutrients.
Cal takes a bunch of lentils.
Yeah, because that's what they are. That's their purpose.
Makes a bar.
But when you glorify food and you make it these larger-than-life things, it's almost... People look at food almost... godlike.
Why do you tell
that's
jokes?
That's why you have fat fucks.
Why do you tell jokes in front of people instead of just giving your opinion to your buddies?
Because I enjoy it.
There you go. Fuck off and eat a dick.
God gave us the ability to taste things.
Yeah, but I don't tell jokes and ruin the quality of someone's health.
It's artistry too, man.
You don't have to eat unhealthy. It's just super fun to.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's something that society has completely... the idea of food has been deformed in what its purpose is.
You just want to hate on it, is it?
I'm not trying to hate on it.
Sounds like it.
Look at America. Look at how America treats food.
Listen, man, I agree that food shows aren't as good now, but I grew up with, like, Yan Can Cook and all those dudes. Those dudes could cook.
Oh, a good cook.
I can argue with you there, Cal.
What was that?
I listen to you every Monday night here, and your jokes... severely affect my mental health, motherfucker.
Nice.
Dan, everybody, I love you.
More of that.
You miserable cunt, I love you.
More of that. How did it work out? Did you girls figure out the bag over there? You were struggling with it. Did you figure
what time
it out?
Are we at here?
The bag. Did you figure out how to do the volcano thing?
They're not listening.
They don't want to acknowledge this.
Nope.
No.
Ignored all right,
we got five. Let's
chicks.
Kill 5 minutes.
Another what?
Let's kill 5 minutes.
Well, I have that other video.
Let's play the other video.
I can play that, and I got a good Gordon Ramsay one for you.
You got a Gordon Ramsay video?
You know Gordon Ramsay had a dwarf porno counterpart that was murdered in Australia?
What?
There's a dwarf version of Gordon Ramsay that did porno. And he got fucking murdered, man.
He put so a dwarf who played a Gordon Ramsay parody in like they do like food show porno now.
I don't know. I didn't watch the porno, K-Trav. I'm just aware of it. I just remembered a line I forgot. Where this is funny.
Wow.
This is funny. Midget strippers are surprisingly more expensive and not half price.
Harder to find.
Well, yeah, they're harder to find. They're a commodity.
I know. Quit fucking being logical with my bit.
Sorry.
Pricks. Just saying, it's obvious.
Pricks.
What's Gordon Ramsay doing?
Get the dwarf porn star.
Who's putting all this in the bin? How many portions are you putting in there?
At least get a picture of the dwarf porn star. Just search Gordon Ramsay dwarf porn star.
What the f*** is this?
Fuck you.
What the hell was that?
Stupid.
There we go.
I'm just saying.
Gordon Ramsay's sex dwarf eaten by badgers?
Beat that. Top that fucking story.
That's not real, though.
It is true.
No.
Dude, this is a fact.
Do you know how small you'd have to be eaten by a badger?
Dude,
you're a new kind of midget.
I do know how small. Dwarf small. That's how small you gotta be eaten by dwarves.
Badgers are so tiny.
And the irony is that Gordon Ramsay can make a delicious badger.
I really don't think this happened.
This did happen.
It can't.
You want to bet? You want to bet money?
I'll put $5 on it.
I bet $5.
There's no way this happened.
It happened.
How are you going to prove this? It's just going to be a bunch of tabloids.
Well, man, you can.
I want to see video of a badger.
Well, what if it was a legitimate red?
Well,
like,
no, it could have been that he was murdered and then eaten by the badger.
Yeah, who would videotape?
I just picture the badger pre-planning murder.
Gordon Ramsay had a dwarf fucking.
I'm going to jump this midget with a knife.
Would you like your last clip?
You want to play this video and then we'll get the fuck out of here?
Yeah, but actually here this ties in with it. I just.
Everyone's playing Risk.
Just tweeted out a show I'm going to be doing September 7th. I'm going to be the ring announcer for a wrestling event, Golden Hearts, September 7th in Scarborough, featuring Bret the Hitman Hart.
Boom.
And I'm going to be doing the ring announcing.
You're going to be doing the in this corner guy?
Huh?
You're going to be in this corner guy?
I'm going to be like making his way to the ring.
Oh, that's it.
Making his way to the ring.
Yeah, I'm going to be the Howard Finkel of the show. So I get to do everyone's introduction.
Nice.
I got a video that I sent it today. Found this online. Things that pro wrestlers do that if you did would be really creepy.
Things pro wrestlers do.
My client is a 3-time employee of the month, best in the world.
How's it going?
Hey man, what are you up to?
I tell you what I'm up to. This Saturday, I'm going to the supermarket, maybe the post office.
You ready to get oiled up?
Just wanted to say thanks for being such a great team member. Oh, I don't like you anymore.
That was silly. Very silly video, okay, Trev.
Is that it?
That is our show. Ben, Twitter?
At Ben Miner, M-I-N-E-R. And I'm in Windsor this weekend at the Comedy Quarry.
Oh, the Comedy Quarry. I hear that club's pretty dece. Pretty dece.
It's going to be nice.
Okay, Trev, what's going on with you? You're doing the wrestling thing?
Wrestling thing September 7th. This weekend, I am in Kingston, Friday, Saturday, with Ryan Denis, Steve Dillon, Art Simeon, and Dave Hudson. It's the last weekend of the Time to Laugh.
Time to Laugh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Time to Laugh
wow.
is closing down, and we're saying goodbye with the,
Time
with
to
the
laugh.
Gala show.
I'm going to miss you, Time to Laugh. Twitter handle?
Oh, I'm at K. Trevor Wilson, the only K. Trevor Wilson on the internet.
Nice. And I'm at Cal Post.
And this week I'm going to be in the lovely Yuck Yucks Vaughn Club. Can you hear the gun in my mouth?
Yo, bro, talk about cars.
Oh, yeah, I just yell.
Yeah.
I like Vaughn. I'm probably one of the few comics. I really love it there. They're a good crowd. That is our show. I hope you enjoyed it this week. I had a lot of fun, despite my fuck the world attitude.
Boom.
Every week. I'm sad. It's not even a fun anger. Usually I'm funny. Charming angry. No? I don't know.
Yep.
Doesn't matter. Anyway, we got great shows here every week. Every Monday we got Opus Live, followed by the CK Podcast.
That's us.
Woo! Every Tuesday we got the Myrnawana Zone, hosted by Matt Myrna.
TMZ.
Really intensive pot show. Every Wednesday we got Weedy Wednesday's stand-up comedy show, 9 o'clock, hosted by the very funny Brian O'Gorman every Thursday.
Brian Gutkick O'Gorman.
He gut kicks. Every Thursday, we got Third Class Thursdays, hosted by the hilarious Hunter Collins.
Big game. Stand-up
variety show. I'll be filling in for him this week, actually. I'll be the host this week.
Nice.
And then every Sunday, we got Stoner Sundays. Open mic. You can get up and do whatever the fuck you want.
Magic. Singing. Beatboxing. A little bit of Irish dancing.
Yeah, you can do that. You can taint lip syncing. I don't know what that is.
Neither do I.
I wish to buy the fabulous Mike Rita,
Little
everybody.
Mikey Rita.
That is our show. I hope you enjoyed the CK Podcast this week. We'll see you next week. Good night, Vapor Central. Good night. Good night.
Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.